Professor Dr. Rajesh Verma. He's assistant professor, Department of Anesthesia, and he's a senior consultant who will be speaking on. He has already, I think some of you must have heard him already on various anesthesia techniques for cosmetic procedures on face. So we requested him to come back. And just let me tell you here that along with the University of Greifswald, Germany, and the University of Rostock, these two German universities have recently announced the launch of MSc 2.5 years MSc program in plasma and aesthetic laser medicine. All right. And in these sessions, in Tuesday sessions, all these speakers who are talking, actually, they are all the faculties, actually. These are the faculty members of the MSc program. And any of you, whether you are a medical doctor or you are a dental doctor, anybody, actually, any of you who would be interested to participate in this MSc PALM program. Understand, let me repeat again, MSc PALM is a state university program. That means the program which will be done actually will be directly, you will be directly enrolled with the University of Greifswald, Germany. And the program would be rolled in collaboration with the University of Rostock, Germany. So these two German universities, along with the other institutions around the world, would be conducting this program. And after completion of this program, after completion of the thesis, actually, you will be awarded MSc, which is a very prestigious tag. And any of you who joins the program, but if you close the program in a year only, if you stop the training in a year only, then you will be awarded DALM, Diploma in Aesthetic Laser Medicine, by the University Medicine Greifswald, Germany. All right. So that is the briefing, actually. And let me welcome Dr. Rajesh here. So welcome, Dr. Rajesh. Nice to have you here again. And sorry to keep you waiting, because I was actually expecting Professor to join in, but just got the news that he is a little occupied. So let's start the session. Over to Dr. or Professor Rajesh Verma, please. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Ajay. Thank you for this nice introduction. So, all the friends who have joined this meeting, today I'll be touching some aspects about anesthesia for cosmetic procedures on face. I'm Dr. Ajay Verma. I'm working as Associate Professor in Department of Anesthesia, Critical Care and Pain Management at Indira Gandhi Medical College, Shimla. So, we'll be discussing anesthesia for cosmetic procedures on face. So a brief introduction. In cosmetic facial surgery practice, the majority of the patients required regional anesthesia. It may be either topical or injected. Aesthetic physicians and surgeons can do a better job on a patient who is comfortable and relaxed and confident. The reputation for excellence in amelioration of pain and discomfort serves as an extraordinary internal marketing enhancer. So if your patient is comfortable in a procedure with you, he doesn't have any pain, so he'll come back and he'll pass the word to other patients also that he was very comfortable while the procedure was done. Conversely, even the most talented cosmetic surgeon can produce negative marketing effects if they have the reputation of causing unnecessary physical or emotional discomfort. So basically, this is broad classification of local anesthetics, which are commonly used. These are divided into amides and esters. The names which have two I's in them, like lidocaine, mepivacaine, bupivacaine, etidocaine, these are amides one. And the names which have only one I in them, like procaine and tetracaine, they are esters one. So this is a broad classification. We use various combination of local anesthetics, and most often the most oftenly used local anesthetic, xylocaine or lidocaine, is often combined with adrenaline so that it enhances its effect. And the effect remains locally concentrated. It doesn't spread to far off areas. So basically, it concentrates in your area of interest only. This combination offers following advantages. It decreases anesthetic absorption and systemic toxicity with improved efficacy, and smaller amounts are required. It prolongs the duration of action, almost doubles it, especially with lignocaine and procaine. It also causes less bleeding at operative site, especially useful on vascular areas with better visualization of operative field, because basically adrenaline causes vasoconstriction locally, so it causes less of the bleeding. So these local anesthetics, which are combined with epinephrine, they have adverse effects also. Like in CNS effects, they can cause drowsiness, circumoral numbness, tingling of tongue, metallic taste, diplopia, blurred vision, tinnitus, respiratory arrest. Basically, for the first sign of local anesthesia toxicity is circumoral numbness. But it happens when you give more than toxic dose, and in procedures on face, it is seldom required. You don't have to worry about it, because you have to give it in volumes 10 to 20, 30 ml, then these things occur. And on facial procedures, you are giving only 1 to 2 ml, maximum 5 ml. So this won't be encountered in your practice. And in CVS, it can cause progressive myocardial depression, arteriovenous block, bradycardia, vasomotor depression. The treatment is obviously CPR. It can also cause allergic reactions like urticaria, angioedema, anaphylaxis, and antihistamines and steroids are required for that. And then often it can cause vasovagal response. And the cold compresses on forehead and neck, Trendelenburg position, and the patient bring him to fresh air. These can help. What are the types of local anesthesia for cosmetic procedures? So first one is topical anesthesia, when you apply the anesthetic on the skin only. Topical anesthesia is the surface application of a local anesthetic to the skin or mucous membrane by means of a spray or by spreading of an ointment. Lidocaine 2% jelly, Emla cream, or ionotophoresis of lidocaine can allow biopsies, electrocauterization of epidermis, or superficial laser surgeries. It provides surface anesthesia to permit painless insertion of a needle, especially in children. We use these creams in our practice. We use these creams for children, because when a child has to be operated, the first difficulty is to put an IV cannula. So if you have put a topical anesthesia, a cream, then it's easy to insert the cannula in a child. And next are the mucosal agents. Topical anesthetic agents are useful on mucosal surfaces. It includes cocaine 4%, benzocaine, tetracaine, and lidocaine 2 to 5% jelly form or ointment form, and lidocaine 10% aerosol forms are also used. So these aerosol forms are generally used to anesthetize the airway or when the procedures are done in mouth or other or nose areas. So basically not meant for your purposes. Next are the cutaneous agents, creams. For producing an anesthesia on intact skin, cream of lidocaine 30% or Amla. Amla is basically a eutectic mixture of local anesthetics, and it have to be applied for variable period of time according to the composition of the Amla. A next very important aspect in practice of aesthetic medicine is tachesthesia. Tachesthesia is what basically you converse with your patient, how you converse with your patients, how, in which environment you keep your patient. So basically it is defined as anesthesia by your words of wisdom. A well-informed patient who is confident of your skill and your care usually needs less anesthesia and analgesia. So tachesthesia basically starts with the patient's first phone call to your office or visit to your website and continues through to your final contact with the patient. It includes all the verbal and non-verbal communication by yourself, your staff, and your operating environment with the patient. So if your patient is comfortable to converse with you, your staff, or is comfortable in your OPD, then he will require less anesthesia or analgesia. Next, special techniques for topical anesthesia. So there are different techniques for topical anesthesia. One of them is cryoanesthesia. You must have used it in your practice. Cryoanesthesia refers to localized application of cold as a means of producing regional anesthesia. You must have noticed when sometime you have a cut, you have a bruise or something, you apply ice and you get relief. So the same principle applies here. Ice is the most useful and safe source of cold when working on the skin. Reduction in the pain receptors in the skin. It causes reduction in the rate of sensory nerve depolarization. It causes inhibition of both the release and the activity of inflammatory mediators and pain-mediating neurotransmitters such as substance P. Activation of the gate control of pain mechanism at the level of spinal cord is responsible for its action. The next one is the vibratory anesthesia. It is a simple, safe, and effective form of anesthesia in dermatology practice. Vibration anesthesia can be explained by the gate theory of pain control. A variety of vibratory massages can be used to produce effective vibratory anesthesia. The vibratory massager should be applied within 1 to 2 centimeters of the site to be treated for approximately 2 to 3 seconds prior to the injection or laser application and should be continued throughout the injection or laser application. Next, the newer techniques, the technology is taking over. So the newer techniques like ionotophoresis is being used. It is introduction of various ions into the skin through the use of electricity used to provide pain relief. So you are inserting the ions through the skin with the help of electricity or other means. Advantages are it avoids pain